What can he produce here for us? Little ball over the top into Gallagher. Gallagher takes a chest down. Oh my god, and it's 2-0 just like that. Former blue and now a baggy. You love to see it. Former Spurs boy. And they whipped in a great cross. Oh my god, you can't be this stupid. Oh my god. It's the same two that combined for the first goal of the tie. Hello my people, how are you doing? I hope you're having a damn great day. Welcome back to the career mode. If things are winding down, we are in the final month of it. I just wanted to show you guys the team. I'm very happy with it. Now, the big question that I have to ask, or the big thing that I'm going to actually do is, I'm about to do a madness. McNamara is going to come off come out of the starting lineup for the likes of Sanko. We will, you know, get him onto the correct game plan and whatnot. But I think as things, you know, tick down, we need a better overall striker, more experienced striker. So McNamara, he's going to be the rotational piece off the bench. I quite like that role for him for now, especially in the crunch moments of the season. And I think, to be honest with you guys, I'll show you guys the league table shortly. We're one or two league wins away from lifting the Premier League title, which is absolutely fantastic. I don't think I could have asked for a better season. Of course, the goal was always top four. But the quality that we have in the squad, it's just risen. It's risen, and I've set expectations and they've broken through them. I've set other expectations and they've gone ahead and thrown them in the bin. That's how well this team has done. So let me show you guys the league standings as well as the potential teams that we have coming up shortly in this episode. Well, isn't that a pretty sight? West Brom sitting at the top, 12 points clear of second place Arsenal. If we go ahead and win our next game, which is versus Chelsea, and I think it is a home game as well, I think we lift the Premier League title, honestly, because that would mean that obviously Arsenal have played a game more than us. We have a game in hand. If we win that game, we go 15 points clear with 4 games to go, and you can only win a max of 12. So that leads me to believe, mathematically wise, it is impossible for us to lose the league title. So all we need is one win in our last, 5 games? And that to me is outstanding, outstanding achievements. And that could also mean that we could focus on other competitions like the Champions League. And as you can see right here in the Champions League, we have got damn near Atletico Madrid. Atletico Madrid, for context, destroyed Liverpool. They absolutely battered them in the quarterfinals. I can't remember who they played. We will also have a look at that when we get to that game. But they are going to be a massive and tough, tough opposition to break up. And that's also why I'm going with Sanko to be the main guy up front for us for those games. He's got physicality. He's got clinicality. He's overall-wise really good, really experienced at this moment in the career mode. So, you know what? Go with what you know. We also have a home game in between those two massive ties versus Bournemouth, as well as, you know, another home game versus Aston Villa. And it just seems to be the time for home games, because coming out of those ties, and obviously out of the Aston Villa game, we've got Man City. So I'm hoping to have the league wrapped up by then, obviously. And then obviously we'll finish off the season versus Newcastle United. Now, if we somehow make it to the final of the Champions League, I don't want to go ahead and say there will be another episode, because we might not make it to the final. But if we do, I will save the FA Cup final as well as the Champions League final for the next episode. I think that's just the best thing to possibly go ahead and do. But right now, confirmed, we have got 8 games. 8 games. Or 7 games, depending on what happens. 7 games in this episode with the possibility of having 8. Okay, so heading into that massive Chelsea tie, just a point is all we need to become champions. Not even a win, a point. A singular point. We won't play for a draw. I want us to win. I want us to go out there and, you know, set the tone for this episode and for the games versus Atletico Madrid. But honestly, like I said earlier, we have set goals and we've absolutely smashed through them. So I am beyond proud of this side. I am going to rotate it a little bit. I want the club captain on the field to lift that trophy. So that does mean that, you know, who will be starting. But I'm very excited for this game. It's something that we should embrace. It's a positive. And I'm so excited for it, honestly. Let's hop on straight into the game. Okay. This could be the game that crowns us as champions. I want us to perform to the best possible, you know, standard. If we're going to be champions and we're you know, going to be crowned the champions of England, we want to give the fans something to be proud of. Of course, we've had an insane season. I nearly said some words, some choice words there. We've had an outstanding season. And we want to tip it off with a performance that the fans will remember. Chelsea defenders are just everywhere. And remember, guys, at one point in the season, we were like almost neck and neck with Chelsea. Well, right now, I think we're like 20 points clear of them, which is absolutely insanity at its finest. Oh my God! And former Chelsea man smashes it home for a 1-0 lead. We have been, you know, in and around their box. Quite happy with that. But yes, at one point this season, we were quite close with Chelsea, and they were like, you know, borderline title rivals. And yeah, I think we're like, what, 20 or 30 points clear of them? It's insanity at its finest. But you know what? I don't give a damn. Because right now, we're up 1-0 to the Baggies, and former Chelsea, former Blue, scores the absolute opener. Focus on that. Sosa's having to defend quite a bit here. He's dropping very deep. No. Oh, that's what I'm talking about. McNamara's brother to the rescue. I still haven't like figured out his name. I can't even remember his name, to be honest. But great block from the youngster. That's what I'm talking about. Poch, hold this L, buddy. Okay. 1-0 up. 25 minutes played. Chelsea definitely do not want us to be crowned champions in front of them. They're trying to ruin our title parade. They do tend to, you know, be in the way of a lot of teams and their celebrations. So good on them to be the party poopers. But they're not going to destroy this party. What can he produce here for us? Little ball over the top into Gallagher. Gallagher takes a chest down. Oh my God, and it's 2-0 just like that. Former Blue and now a Baggy. You love to see it. No. God damn it. Okay, just before halftime, I think it's Action Jackson. He's obviously opened up the scoring for Chelsea on the day. It's okay. We're still 2-1 up. Things are going according to plan from how I see things. A little bit of a mishap in the midfield and bad communications in the back line. And essentially, McNamara has been sucked into that wider right channel, and that's not great. So it's left our goalkeeper very exposed there. Making a driving run, passes it straight through. It's Vivian versus McNamara. McNamara flashes one across the face of goal, and Sanchez gets gloves to it. Okay, Matt O'Reilly, he's got an assist already today. Can he get another? On the forehead! Never mind, never fear. McNamara is here. It's fine, it's alright. Little chip up. Little dink over. Flashes it! Oh my goodness, and Sanchez, I think he may have been beaten. But we can't keep the ball trajectory down. And Carlos Augusto is coming off for Chelsea. Poch making a big time change. And he's bringing on Madueke. Now, I was very interested in signing him in the beginning of the season. I just decided not to. As I thought McAtee was probably a better option. And to be honest, we've had some iffy moments with McAtee. And maybe Madueke would have been a better fit. But the good moments that McAtee's produced. The Man United Champions League game. That is levels. There's levels to this stuff, you know. Oh, McNamara, he's made a great run, but so has Haraldsson. And this time, it's Haraldsson! Oh my God, it's off the crossbar. And it's a little, oh my goodness me, captain, my captain. He could not open the scoring. Jed Wallace is staying on this field for as long as possible. If we lift this title, I do not want my captain, who's been with me since day dot, day number one, day number uno, I don't want him off the field. He needs to lift that trophy. So Haraldsson will be coming off, along with Magic coming on for McNamara. I'm also thinking the potential of the other McNamara coming off, Kuto swapping with Kelly and Branthwaite, and Kuto taking up that left-hand position. Wallace is going to be dead on his feet. I don't care. He will be here for the full 90 minutes to lift that goddamn trophy. Okay, we've got a corner kick as well. I'm thinking now, let's put on a bit more of an in-swinger for Wallace to take. And maybe he can land one on somebody's forehead. I see it. I see it. You see it. We all see it. Frickin' Rashford FC. Here we are. Kuto's on. Fantastic. And Branthwaite. I don't know how many goals he's got, but he's got so many. It's un-bloody well believable. You just know. When he's beaten his man with the run, he's always going to flick it on. He's so good with it. And Sanchez is absolutely crap. So it makes the most sense. Good switch of play into McAtee. Wins the header nicely. Keeps it up this side of the field, and that should be the final whistle. Not of our season, but until we are officially confirmed as goddamn champions of England. Now, I don't know if there will be a trophy celebration. We're running on the field. There actually might be. Obviously, there's still, what, four games or so to play? But what's so important about this is we can now shift our focus onto the Champions League. Although, right here, right now, I'm not focused about that. I'm focused about these celebrations. To be honest, I didn't expect this to happen. I expected to play at least another season, and we still might. But I didn't expect us to win the Premier League in season number 4 of this career mode. We've built an absolute legendary team. We've been insane. We've been incredible. Where is the trophy? Where is the trophy? This better not be a glitch. The trophy's not even there. God damn it. EA, man. Fix your game. This is so important. I have a picture looking like a Spurs fan now. Look. The only title Spurs will ever lift is this. And it's not even there. That's a disgrace, mate. Absolute disgrace. God. It kind of ruins the whole, like, you know, thing of we've won the title. The title's imaginary. Look, what are you lifting? Spurs trophy cabinets. Show the fans nothing. That's what Spurs do every season. Anyways, let's focus on the Atletico Madrid game. Okay, so just taking a look at the quarterfinal results. AC Milan ended up beating Arsenal. Napoli ended up beating Bayern Munich. Wow. And obviously Atletico Madrid beat Borussia Dortmund, and we smashed Man United 7-2. Absolutely insane. So obviously that does mean we're facing Atletico Madrid in the semifinals, and Napoli versus AC Milan. An all-Italian semifinal on the other side of the bracket, and a Spain versus England approach for this side. It's going to be very tough, but I have faith in the boys. Let's have a look at the press conference. Okay, press conference time. Yep, a real chance of going through to the final. We really do, to be honest. Like, and I'm not trying to hype up my team here, but AC Milan versus Napoli. I think that the semi-final of Atletico Madrid versus West Brom, I think that's more of a final than potentially a West Brom versus a Napoli, or a West Brom versus an AC Milan, or vice versa with Atletico Madrid in that. So, this is going to be the biggest test of this campaign, the UCL campaign. Atletico Madrid, I think the first leg is away, which is going to be very tough. They're going to sit back, they're going to be compact. Diego Simeone, terrorist football type approach. They're going to be physical, they're going to be brutal. And that's also why I've gone with Sancho up front to start in this specific game, because I think he can handle that. His running off the ball is immaculate, his pressing is great. So, you know what, football's played on the pitch. Let's see what happens. Now, I have made an absolute behemoth call. I've put Maggio in as that number 10. I think we're going to whip in a lot of balls. We need strikers that are in the box waiting patiently to try and get on the end of them. And I need, you know, target men. Maggio and Sancho definitely do that. As well as McNamara does come out for Saar. And I swapped Saar and Branthwaite around. Otherwise, this is going to be the team for the first leg of the semi-finals. Okay, Atletico kicking things off here. Like I said in the press conference, we need to be on it. We need to be alert. Terrorist football at its best, but very good football when it's flourishing and it's working. And to be honest, it must be working if they've gone this far in the Champions League. And they've got Ramos. I think this has gone Saar Ramos, former PSG man. They've got Pedro Porro as well, former Spurs boy. And they've whipped in a great cross. Oh my God, you can't be this stupid. You can't allow Dan Juma that much space in the box. I expect more from Lloyd Kelly and flipping Branthwaite to do more. God! They've got a good team here, people. They've got a really good team. They've worked it down the flank there. Porro's whipped in a fantastic ball. Former Spurs teammates linking up very nicely at Atletico Madrid, and we're 1-0 down early on in the tie. That's not great, is it? No, it's not. It's a great diving header, though. See, a lot of the creativity is coming from that double pivot, which we need. Because Maggio is obviously playing as that secondary type striker. Sosa? I'll take that. Forcing a save from Oblak. And I think Lamar is going to get booked. I don't know what for. Anyways, never mind. Never mind, never fear. O'Reilly is here. Lamar did get booked too. Okay, we're going to put in a great cross here. Please. On somebody's forehead. Branthwaite! Okay, never mind. Haraldsson. Maggio, back into Haraldsson, lays it off nicely. Connor Bradley, he's making a run, he's taking on his man, he's whipped into the back post area, and you know who's there, my boy Sancho. Sancho from season 2 has just, the trajectory has just done this. I know this season, He hasn't started as many games as what he would have liked, but we have used him so goddamn effectively. Bradley with a superb cross. Both goals coming from out wide play. And that just shows you back post attack is flipping amazing. Oblak almost getting gloves to that, which would have been horrendous. But throwing his whole body at it, he knows what it's all about. And it's 1-1, back in the game, let's go. Madja, what is he? Oh, look at that space down that right flank. Great little inside run from Connor Bradley into Madja yet again. Back into Connor Bradley, lays it off to Sosa. Sosa looking for that little acute pass into O'Reilly. And Atletico Madrid are doing their goddamn best in trying to, you know, eliminate space. Look at that, they're just closing us down every time. But we've recycled it nicely! Oh my god, and Sanko has turned the game on its head at the Wanda Metropolitana Stadium. I think that's there. Or is it the Jose Calderon? I can't keep up with the names. They change their name like every like 20 years. But point is, in the away leg, we have scored 2 goals. Now that means absolutely blitz nothing. But we are leading this tie right now, 2-1. And it's all down to your boy's genius of taking out McNamara, realizing this is not the game for him, and starting Sanko. 2 of the biggest goals of this West Brom career mode. Almost, boys. Almost! Let's go! Sanko into the space! Go, Sanko! Make sure Tapsoba doesn't catch you. Sanko with a hat-trick! Oh my god, we are on fire! That honestly, that early goal had my head like, oh no, this could, we could be doing something bad here. Sanko. Also, that pressing from McAtee and Sanko together, brilliant, absolutely superb. Atletico, you're in a bit of an issue, a bit of a problem here. A bit of a sticky situation, you could say. Oblak, not good enough to get there. Hold this L. And I do think that this dual striker tandem has definitely helped with the build-up play. It's occupied multiple centre-backs so that they can't just focus on Sanko, for example. Oh my god! And that, there we go. That's an Oblak save right there. That's a reflex save. That's perfect for what Oblak's known for. Sanko just squeezing into the little half space, tucking the ball through. I must say, Atletico Madrid, they've been at 6s and 7s in their defensive rotations, and we've been at 10s and, oh, 9s and 10s. Deep ball whipped into the back post area. That's not good enough, to be honest. Lloyd Kelly putting it back in to O'Reilly. O'Reilly, what are you going to do with this? Into Sanko. Into Madja. Madja in some space. Takes a touch and a fantastic finish. And it's 4-1 on the day. You can't. It's becoming undeniable now. We might be favorites for this goddamn Champions League final. We might be favorites for a treble. We've already secured the Prem literally in the last game. And I don't want to get overexcited here. But we're 4-1 up in the first leg. Away from home. Versus Atletico Madrid, who could have potentially been, or might have been, the absolute favourites to go all the way and win this whole thing. Bit of a hospital ball into the goalkeeper, but it's fine. We've come away with it quite well. Sanko, he's made a great run in behind here. Oh my god. Sanko makes it 5-1. Boys, I'm honestly thinking, I'm not going to simulate it. I'll play at least this game. If we score more goals, I'm going to definitely have to simulate that second game, because there will be no enjoyment in that second leg whatsoever. Where we can afford to make changes now. Sosa's going to come out for Cullen. We can afford to actually enjoy ourselves, which is strange for a semi-final versus Atletico Madrid. Yeah, I'm going to keep Wood and McNamara on the bench. The other McNamara does come on, though, as that striker. Gallagher's going to come in, Couto as well, and of course Cullen. Okay, there are the changes. Go do your things, boys. These boys that are coming off have worked incredibly hard. Great save. Great save, Woodman. We don't want to give them any extra goals. We want to make sure that we retain a 4-goal lead going into that second leg. And it's a great save yet again from Woodman, you absolute beast. Okay, Simeone, he's low-key losing his brains now. He's like, what the hell's happening? How have West Bromwich Albion, a team that he's probably never heard of, come here and dictated the pace of play, scored the goals, ran the show? Well, it's because of Brom squad. Oh, Connor Bradley got fouled off the ball there, ref. And Leia, or Leie. Oh, he's almost caused some issues there. He's screaming for that ball to come back to him. Oh my goodness. Into Connor. Gallagher! Oh my god! And that is a 5-goal advantage heading into the second leg. Oh my goodness me. Incredible. Absolutely incredible. Connor Gallagher, just come on, made an instant impact as a sub. Okay, so I haven't gone with a fully rotated side, but I have rotated adequately. Kuto's come in, Sars come in, of course. Mulan and McNamara also come in, and of course, Jed Wallace starts on the right. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know how Bournemouth are going to approach this game, because right now I have no stress or pressure on me. So, like I say, if we lose, we lose. If we win, well, fantastic. I'm not chasing any records or anything like that. It's about retaining fitness, retaining, you know, the boys have match fitness. And we don't, you know, crumble under the pressure and pick up injuries. We obviously did lose Timber recently, so we need to make sure that the team that we have right here on the field, they can just go through the motions and effectively see out the game. Great ball into Mulan. This could be a great attack. They've covered the space and Mulan's forced a save from the goalkeeper. And I must say, guys, obviously first half's done, it's 0-0. I'm not really enjoying this game. There's no enjoyment, there's nothing to chase. So what I'm thinking is, simulating this one, obviously playing the Atletico Madrid game, but there's no massive enjoyment. I mean, we ended up drawing 0-0. I'm not chasing anything. Like that, the race is over. It's done. We've won it. I mean, even the other teams in and around us, they're dropping points now. So do we just simulate not the rest of the season per se, but, you know, maybe play the City game, simulate the Aston Villa game? I don't know. Like I said, there's nothing I'm actually chasing because we're so far and away ahead of everybody else, it doesn't really matter too much whether we drop points or not. I think that's what we're going to do. We're going to play this game or a little bit of this game. If we score any goals, it's game over. And we're going to simulate the Aston Villa game and then end off the episode with playing the City game and obviously simulating the Newcastle one. Okay, press conference time. Let's have a look here. We are absolutely delighted that we mashed up this lot in the first leg, but the tie's not over. We've seen Barcelona versus PSG, anything can happen. We need to go in there, focus, we have the home support on our side. We're going to mash them up. Why am I standing up all of a sudden? Okay, we won't get distracted. We have a 5-goal lead. Go there, stroke the ball around the back, play it through the middle. Hopefully score some goals, enjoy the game. No glimmers of hope, nothing. And early on, Pedro Porro, just like how he did it at oh my god. It's the same two that combined for the first goal of the tie. Pedro Porro into Danjuma. Why are you you are 6-2 down, mates. You can effectively win this game 4-0, and I don't even have to care. Great ball over the top into McAtee. Little bit of backspin, he's taking a great touch too. Get him! Oh, and of course, Oblak is like one of the best shot stoppers in the world. McAtee testing him from distance, not too shabby. Haraldsson this time puts in a great ball onto the forehead of nobody. McNamara is there recycling the play very nicely. Haraldsson looking for that back post run. Oh, middle of the goal! And it's another great save from Oblak. Well, you know, we are losing, but I don't really mind too much, to be fair. Again, a good whip, and it's a fantastic save from Oblak yet again. He has single-handedly, excuse the pun, kept them in the lead. On the edge of our box, McNamara is there to clear it, wins it back, and we lose it on the edge of the area, and they've got a shot off, and they've scored. Okay, well, it's now 6-3, and we're 2-0 down. Danjuma, the danger man. Okay, slight panic stations, I'm not going to lie to you guys. Okay, we are going to make some changes. I think it's a requirement, it's a necessity. Gallagher's going to come out for Madja. McNamara is going to come on for Sanko. McAtee has not been that great in this one. He's not fully match fit either, which is probably the massive reason why. McNamara is going to come out for Kuto, and obviously we're going to do the usual swap of Kelly and Branthwaite in the middle with Kuto and Bradley on the wider defensive positions. But yeah, I'm going to make those changes for now. The good holder play from Madja into McNamara, immediately in behind, making an instant impact versus Tapsoba. McNamara pops off a shot, and Oblak is there yet again. Now, I know we are losing 2-0, but the amount of saves that Oblak has been forced into making is absolutely unreal. Madja this time, his holder play in like the first 5 minutes of him being on the field has been absolutely what we've been missing. And I see Haraldsson running into that space. Tapsoba making a late movement. Gets there. Oh my goodness me! And it's the young gun himself. McNamara makes it 7-3 on aggregate. We're still a goal down, but we've killed this tie off. Beautifully done on the break. Haraldsson combines magnificently with McNamara. Beautiful. Look at this. Just almost before he gets cut out. Little post, a back post tap in. Fantastic. Oh, Madja into the space. Plays it in for McNamara. And that fantastic... Oh my god, no. No, no, no. How have I missed that? Oh, I was lining up the line of... And that two-goal advantage that they thought they had in this game was erased. Never mind, I'll sort that in the back pocket. There's 5 minutes or so to go in this one. 7-3 up. Effectively, tie was done before the game even started. Madja this time. Okay, well, we might be able to still say the line. Cullen! And just like that, the two-goal advantage that they thought they had created is gone. Madja. Little ball roll around the one, around two. And oh my god, you absolute king. He makes it 3-2 on the day, 9-3 on aggregate. We still win the game because of this man right here. Benching him, to be honest, was a mistake. Having him up front, using his physicality versus, you know, the Atleti back line. It's insane. It's massive. And he is just coming into some insane form to end off the season. Just when we need it, to be honest. Okay, and there you have it. It will be an AC Milan versus a West Bromwich Albion final. Now, that is going to be very, very cool. But we're going to simulate through the rest of the season, end of the episode, and be sure to come back for the next episode, which might potentially be the final ever episode of the West Bromwich Albion career mode. So yeah, I just decided I'm not going to have any joy in playing, you know, Aston Villa or, you know, Manchester City. So just simulate through them. If we win, we win. If we don't, we don't. Like I said, it makes no major difference. Obviously, we lost to Aston Villa. It makes no difference to me if we win those games or not. And we ended up drawing with City, which is it's okay, I guess. And for the last game of the season, we end up beating Newcastle United. So, yes, I'm going to have a look at the standings, you know, and all that good stuff. Okay, so the final standings appear like this. West Brom in first, a whole 10 points clear of Arsenal in second, who were 6 points clear of Liverpool in third, and who were 5 points clear of Man City in fourth. Spurs round out the top 5 with 70 points. That's not too bad for them. Crystal Palace, though, they had a very good underrated season. Good for them. Nottingham Forest as well. They started off very strong, but they kind of tailed off midway through. Man United finishing 10th, Wolves finishing behind Man United, and let's not forget, when Wolves beat us in the beginning of the season, they were first, and they were first for quite a while, and they fell off a cliff. But yeah, those are the standings. The people who get relegated are Bournemouth, unfortunate, Sheffield United, of course, and Burnley, with Brentford and Everton, or Brentford specifically, you know, just surviving with the skin on their teeth. Everton, you know, 16th, 10 points clear of Brentford, so they, in the end, the relegation battle went down to 3 teams, Brentford, Burnley, and Sheffield United, with Brentford essentially winning that, keeping their Premier League position intact. But yeah, it's a bit sad, Bournemouth going down, but we do get jackpots back next season. So, if there is going to be another season, at least we have some young talent coming back from their very successful loans. Okay, so just taking a look at the, you know, the stats for the season so far. Of course, we do have 2 games left, so you can add your own stats and onto that. But for now, at the end of the Premier League season, crown champions, going into an FA Cup final as well as a Champions League final in the next episode, we've got Branthwaite as well as O'Reilly tying for the most games played. 17 goals. 17 goals. Some strikers don't even get 17 goals in a season. This is a man that's had very few chances in front of the net, and when he's had them, he's taken them with both hands, or his head, you could say, and he's been a major catalyst in helping us get to this point in the season. So he finishes with 17 goals. O'Reilly with 7 and 20. Again, a mad stat. 20 assists, 14 of them coming in the Prem, 5 in the Champions League with 4 goals also in the Prem and 2 in the Champions League. Not too bad. Woodman finishes the season with 13 clean sheets, 12 in the Premier League as well. Lloyd Kelly with only the 1 goal to show for it. Sosa, though, like, this man was the actual DM of the side. He very rarely got forward. But to come away with 3 goals and 9 assists is absolutely insane. As well as our captain leading the way in the assist column. 25 and 6 for him. That's, again, craziness. Haraldsson with 9 and 13. That's a really good first season for him. Now this is what I wanted to see. This is my boy right here, you know. 88 overall, 11 assists and 5 goals for the season. That's Trent numbers. Slightly below Trent, you could say. But those are some really good Trent numbers. And that was the you know, image I had in my head when I bought him. I was like, you're going to be the next Trent. You're going to be the West Brom Trent. And he's done a very good job with it. As for Conor Gallagher, 26 and 24. Those are Thierry Henry-esque type stats. Kuto, you know, being very limited to his actual natural position. But finishing the season with 5 assists and 2 goals. Sanko, 24 and 6. Badger, 29 and 11. Wowza. Okay. Timber didn't score for the club, unfortunately. Did get injured as well, but he played 40 games. McAtee, 4 and 12. Cullen, in a very reserved role for the season, 6 and 5. McNamara, 25 and 9. I think that puts him as, what, our third best goal scorer of the season, having only played 33 games. And he also got 9 assists in that time as well, which is, again, 34 goal contributions in 33 games. That is Erling Haaland numbers, I'm telling you right now. 71 overall only. This young kid has got the brightest future I've ever seen. Saar didn't get a goal or an assist this season, but 32 games played. Mühlen, yeah. I'm a bit disappointed with Mühlen. I expected a lot more from him. But in 11 games, 2 goals and 2 assists. Now, Martin McNamara, James's brother, slightly older brother, 9 appearances for the club, not too bad, 1 clean sheet in that time, no goals, no assists so far. Wood, 1 goal and an assist, that's fantastic to be honest, although I think that goal wasn't for us, I think it was for Hull City, so he definitely got the assist though. I remember him in the last episode assisting, I think it was Maja. Potts this season, only making 8 appearances, which is a bit annoying, and then we've got Swift, Peacock, Farrell, only 3 appearances for him. And then a few other players I don't really care to mention. But so far, the stats are looking fantastic. And there you have it, guys. We're going to end off the episode right here, right now. I hope you have enjoyed it. If you have, hit that like button down below. And be sure to come back for the absolute final of all finals. It could be the final episode as well. If we go on and win the FA Cup versus Leeds, it'll be amazing. As well as if we go on and win the Champions League versus AC Milan. That could essentially be the best way to wrap up what will be considered the best career mode I have personally done on this channel. So, if you guys can, hit that like button down below. Have a great day, and I'm out of here.